when we studied statistics, we saw that we had a raw data, and to get a sense of it, to have the central tendency of the data, what we did was we found three things: mean, median, and mode. Okay, what did mean tell us? Mean told us that if it was evenly distributed, how much marks each will get, and that gave us a rough idea about what is happening. Fine. So if the average marks is very high, it means maybe the class is good or things are going well. If it is very low, it means there is something wrong with the class. And these things are required, because as you start going higher, you cannot go into the micros of the things, right? So the first thing, why statistics came in, why mean, median, mode came in, because we want to understand the health of the system without going into much of data. Okay, so 3, 4, 5 data I should have, say as someone who is controlling a company like IBM in 160 countries. Okay, they cannot go by the minutes or micros. Okay, they have to be on the macros. What's your profit? What's your increase over profit? Okay, what's your retrenchment? What's your sales figures? They cannot go into how many staplers did you consume and how many pins did you spend, right? So that is something called the central tendency. So we'll try to find out that this experiment, what is the mean and what do you mean by that? Okay, suppose in that experiment in which we defined X as the random variable, that was a game, right? Game where you got rupees 2 for every head and you lost rupees 1.5 for every tail. Okay, and you were allowed 3 flips of a coin, right? And coin tossed thrice, and we found out the sample space was, again this I have to write time and again, HHT and THH, okay, and HTT and THT and TTH and TTT, correct. And we had found out the sum that he gained or lost. So XHHH was rupees 6. For all these three, it was 1.5. HHT, HTH, THH, it was 1.5. Then it became HTT is 2 and he lost 3, so minus 1. THT, so minus 1. And TTH, so minus 1. And TTT, so it is minus 4.5. Now, why I'll be interested in the mean of this? See, if you have flipped it thrice, you'll only get one of these. You'll get only one of these. So maybe if you do it 8 times, you'll get all these, or if you do it 100 times. Now, if you are interested in finding out whether I should go for this game or not, okay, whether on an average I'll gain money or lose money. Okay, I told you that all these probabilistic calculations, they came from uncertainties, right? Uncertainties in war, okay? Uncertainties in gambling. Gambling is a great thing to understand, you know? It's a great thing. Why is it great? Because you have to take decisions based on small amount of information, okay? and it is not as random as it seems. So maybe though this looks so random, if you have to decide whether I should go for this game, will I on an average lose or gain the money, then what do? We go for the mean of the random variable. Okay, on an average, what is the expected loss? That's why it is also called expectation of x. Okay, so what do you get out of it? Fine. Now I have this probability distribution that we had defined earlier. So maybe
2.5.
Which one?
Oh
yes, 2.5. So it is 2.5. Yeah, it is 2.5. Fine. Sorry. Okay. So you understand? 4 minus 1.5, 2.5. Fine. So now what are the values that the random variable is taking? It is taking a value, say -4.5. And it's taking a value -1. It's taking a value 2.5. It's taking a value 6. Can I find its probability distribution? So what is the probability of this happening? 1/8. What is the probability of this happening? 3/8. What is the probability of this happening? 3/8. What is the probability of this happening? 1/8. Now you see, though there is a chance that you'll suddenly win 6 rupees, but the probabilistically it is very, very low. It's only 12.5% chance that you'll win rupees 6. Also, there is only 12.5% chance that you'll lose all. Okay, 4.5 rupees you have to give from your own pocket. Okay, so what happens if I have to decide whether I should go for this? See, it may not be as stupid as this gambling. Why should you, after all, be so much after 4.5 and 6 rupees? But the thing is that you might be going for a project, okay? Which, and these may be the returns out of that, and maybe returns on risks. And these are the probabilities. Now, it is very difficult to calculate the probability, you know, in the real life, that you say that there is 20% chance that it will fail. But still, if you have got some amount of hazy idea that yes, it might fail due to these reasons and the probability of these happening is that, then fine. Okay? Just a crude estimate if you want to develop, then what do? The value that I have, I multiply with probability, because that will give you on an average. What had you done? Let me take you back. What had you done when you were finding out means? This was x1, this was f1, this was x2, this was f2, this was xn, that was fn. What did we do for finding out the mean? We first of all tried to sum it up. So what did we do? We multiplied this by this, this by this, this by this. So we did for mean, we did summation xi fi and we divided it by summation fi. So all the total number. Okay, I divide with that. Now just try to think. This is the frequency. If I divide it by the total, that is summation fi, what does it become? It kind of becomes probability fi. If f1 I divide by total number, the total frequency, suppose it is the total is 100 and this is 10. So if I divide 10 by 100, it becomes, it is actually occurring, this thing is occurring 10 times out of 100. So that is the probability. Probability of this occurring is 10%. Now I apply the same thing here. You understand why? Why I say so is this. X bar is equal to summation xi fi divided by summation fi. Now if I divide this by summation fi, what does it become? It actually becomes P1, P2, Pn. Do you understand that? It actually becomes that. So I do exactly the same thing here. What I'll do, if I do xi pi upon summation pi, what is summation pi? 1. So in effect, if I do summation xi into pi, that should be the mean. Do you understand that? And that's how the mean is defined for a probability distribution. That's why and that's how. PI kya hai? Probabilities hai? These are the probabilities. Ye. Probability distribution mein probability. Huh. So now I do exactly that. So you multiply this by this. So you get minus 4.5. So mean of that. Mean denoted by mu is minus 4.5 into 1 by 8 minus 1 into 3 by 8 plus 2.5 into 3 by 8 plus 6 into 1 by 8. So what do we get? 8 becomes our denominator. This is minus 4.5 minus 3 plus 7.5 plus 6. That gives me 13.5 minus 4 is 9, 9 minus 3 is 6, 6 by 8. Okay. So if you play this game on an average, summation pi is 1. Summation pi is 1. Actually, if you see this, now let me go into a bit of detail. I was finding x bar as x1 f1 plus x2 f2 plus x3 f3 plus xn fn that divided by summation fi, that will be xi into fi upon summation f1 upon summation fi plus x2 f2 upon summation fi plus x3 f3 upon summation fi plus xn fn upon summation fi. Now what is this? This is what I am calling pi. So it actually becomes x1 p1 plus x2 p2 plus x3 p3 plus xn pn. And that's why it is this. That's why. So it is the same thing. Why? Because if someone says I do this 100 times or say I do it say 80 times, that means 10 times you will get this 30 30 10. That's how on an average your throws will be distributed. So on an average, if you play this game, you will be a winner of 6 upon 8. About 80 paise will be your profit. That means on an average, you will not lose this game. You can lose this game, fine. But if you do it sufficient number of times, you will come out with a profit. You get it? You will come out with a profit. And you should understand, see, the probability, these are the same probabilities. Here, the probability of this loss, the loss is only minus 1 and the profit is 2.5. Here 1 upon 8 and 1 upon 8, okay, here the loss is, the chances are equal, but the amount of money lost here is 4.5 and the amount of money gained here is 6. Just think commonsensically. You have the same probabilities, but the loss is less and profit is more. You didn't get it. This is a probabilistic mean. I am not saying that in one chance what will happen, but even in one chance, your the probability is more. There is only 12.5% probability that you lose 4.5. Get it? But on an average, if you insist on playing the game 10 times, then you will be a winner, not a loser. Normally the games that the casinos design, they are like that. So they have got a statistician, a probabilistic man who sits behind, calculates the probability, and then lets go. Okay? And people are falling over each other, all in hope of gaining, and he is counting on what? This probability. He knows that if 1,000 people play my game, I am the winner. Whatever you lose or whatever you gain, that's not my bloody headache. You, someone gains $1 million, someone loses a $10 million here. Okay, so they are loaded in their favor. If you come out and calculate the probability of whatever game you are trying to play in a casino, they are the winner. Okay, so maybe if you are able to compute these, you'll never enter a casino. Okay, they are designed like that. Or you can put your own conditions such that it favors you. Mm-hmm. But they'll never allow that.